Hello everyone, myself J.K. Vaishnav from third year of pharmacy, studying in Siddharth College of Pharmacy. Today we discuss about the antiemetic drugs. The antiemetic drugs are used for treating the parasite infection. These drugs either kill or expel the infesting parasites. They kill parasites by binding to nerves and the muscle cells and causing paralysis and eventually death of the parasite, blocking the transport of glucose by the cells and thus causing paralysis of the parasite. And third is inhibiting the formation of the young worm from the adult worm. There are the various types of the worms present in our body. First is parasite worm, then pin worms, egg worms, and hook worms. The classification of the antiemetic drugs are in 5 types. First is piperazine. Example of piperazine is diethyl carbamazine citrate. And example of benzimidazole is albendazole, mebendazole, thiazole. There are various marketed products are available of the albendazole, mebendazole. Third is heterocycline. In heterocycline, there are two types, quinolone and isoquinolone. Example of quinolone is oxandrolone and isoquinolone is tazobactam. The fourth type is natural product. Example is ivermectin. And last is amide, salicylamide. Example is niclosamide. The mechanism of action of the piperazine is it is bind to the GABA muscle receptor and leads to the hyperpolarization, and due to the hyperpolarization there is a paralysis of worm and the worm is killed under the body and expelled through the anus. The adverse effects of the antiemetic drug is causing diarrhea, nausea, abdominal pain, and have attended its use in a heavy infestation. Allergic reactions are causes due to the antiemetic drugs. Loss of hearing is also possible due to the use of the antiemetic drug. Granulocyte capillaria have been reported in high doses. And the therapeutic uses of the antiemetic drug is using treatment of most forms of tapeworms. Antiemetic drugs are used to treat people who are infected by the helminth